Vítám vás u našeho dnešního pártu z datadisku o víně a krvi. V dnešní epizodě budeme plnit vedlejší úkol cvrlikání zaláskovaného rytíře, takže se setkáme s Guillaumem de Lanfol, synovcem Palmerina, našeho přítele, a s Guillaumem jsme už měli co dočinění, bojoval s Obrem a Charlejem. A Guillaume má něco na srdci. Má pro nás zakázku, úkol, který v dnešním pártě budeme plnit. Bude to docela dlouhý úkol, takže se máte na co těšit.
Your wound. Feeling better?
It's healing splendidly, though I am to avoid trouble for some time. To be frank, that is precisely why I wish to speak with you.
Want me to stand in for you? Take on some trouble on your behalf?
That could very well be the case. You see, there is a maiden. Nay, a lady. I suspect someone's cast an ill spell upon her. A curse, perhaps.
What makes you think she might be cursed?
You must keep all I say to yourself, I beg you. I would never dare to be so indiscreet normally, yet I'm troubled about her, for her. Vivian shuns the company of others. Though the fairest maid at court, she keeps men at a distance. I thus determined I would resort to trickery.
Trickery? That even befitting of a knight?
In war, yes. And what is love if not battle? As it were, one evening I crouched in hiding outside her seamstress's home. As Vivian emerged from it, I too emerged, ever so gently but convincingly collided with her, then promptly offered to escort her home. She consented. At first, all augured well. I proposed a more scenic route. She agreed. I made kindly forays into conversation, and she even began to respond as we neared the end of our route.
Then suddenly,
mid-speech, from her mouth there flew a most hideous shriek. I stopped stone cold in my tracks while she turned red, then promptly ran off. I did not give chase that time. I attempted to approach her on several ensuing occasions, to learn what had happened, for I feared she had become entangled in some trouble. I noted that often, come night, she ventures into the woods, where I've seen her walk about a glade near a pool. I've striven on occasion to follow her, but lost track each time. It seemed then she'd melted into the air.
Tell me more about Vivian. Who is she? What's her story?
She's Her Enlightened Highness's lady-in-waiting. Her mother was a lady-in-waiting, her father a knight. That is all I've learnt, for the Duchessa grows angry when asked about her. Vivian spends her days within the palace walls. Yet we are in luck, for she has been named a tourney's patroness this year. Thus, each participant will be granted an audience with her.
Got a problem then. See, I'm not a participant.
I've devised a solution already. You shall take my place in the lists and thus gain the chance to speak to her.
I was looking forward to winning the tourney, very much so. Yet for Vivian, I am prepared to sacrifice anything.
Fine, I'll look into it. Gotta admit, piqued my curiosity.
I shall be forever in your debt. Now, we must ensure you are not eliminated from the tourney before you can meet Vivian.
Meaning?
Could you show me how you shoot, ride, and fight, perchance? And you must learn the tourney rules, know how to apply them in practice. I did not mean to suggest I doubt your abilities. Everyone must train, even a witcher.
Besides, the tourney contests must surely differ, require skills you don't usually apply, races above all. The choice is yours. Where shall we start?
Apply all the skills you mentioned on a daily basis, and against monsters, not targets and dummies. Don't need any training. Going straight to the tourney grounds to sign up.
Zajdi do přihlašovacího stanu a zapiš se na přebor. Náš Geralt se zúčastní rytířských turnajů. Jakožto rytíř Sir Geralt z Rivie. Půjdeme do stanu, ale ještě předtím, než tam půjdeme, bychom se mohli podívat na nějaké účastníky. Tady máte prince Anseise, to je syn královny Mev. Přesně ta královna, která pasovala Geralta na Syra Geralta z Rivie. To vše se dozvíte v knížkách. Dále tu máme další známou knižní postavu, dokonce byla i v Zaklínačově dvojce na začátku při obléhání hradu Lavalet. Měl by být někde tady. Tady je totiž stan Tylese z Dorndalu. Ale jak vidím, tak Tylese tady není, je tady truhla. Sebereme mu tady aspoň sedlo, které použijeme při turnaji. A pojďme Tylese najít. Našel jsem tady Tylese, jak tady buzeruje kolem jdoucí. Ten má vždycky na Geralta strašné štěstí. Vidíte tu jizvu, kterou má na čele? Tak tu si udělal sám při souboji s Geraltem. Taková hezká nostalgie. Vidí Geralta, radši zdrhá. Každopádně pojďme se přihlásit do turnaje, pojďme se stát rytíři. Turnaje se zúčastní i Palmerin, který má stan napravo. A dále známe postavy jako například Renfarn, Van Atre a tak dále. Ale teďka pojďme přihlásit rytíře, který jim všem vytře zrak. Est flows in the veins.
Greetings. Want to join the lists?
Naturally. We must first see to formalities, however. At Guillaume's request, I have looked into your personal history in its heraldic aspects.
Really? What did you come up with?
My findings show you may take part as Geralt of Rivia.
What a surprise.
Or as the Honorable Ravix of Forhorn. It's not every year we have a combatant who can boast of two crests. Which do you prefer?
Ravix of Forhorn? How'd you manage to dig that up?
Here in Toussaint we treat heraldry very seriously. One visit to the ducal archives. That is all I needed to acquire the necessary information. Ravix of Forhorn was the name under which you attended a feast honoring Princess Pavetta, daughter of Queen Calanthe of Sintra, on the occasion of her 15th birthday.
That's actually right. Kinda curious what you could have learned about Geralt of Rivia.
In the year 1267, a certain Geralt, a member of the Witch's Guild, was knighted by Queen Meave and dubbed Geralt of Rivia. This was in honor of his distinguished service at the Battle of the Bridge, said structure spanning the Yaruga. But I wager you know of which battle I speak.
Yeah, those were the days. Cahir and I led a fistful of Nordlings against an entire Nilfgaardian battalion. Won that battle just because we absolutely had to cross the river. I'm Geralt, not about to fight under a false name.
You may now take the shield bearing your crest.
I'm a witcher. Shields aren't something witchers ever use in combat.
Who mentioned using it in combat? Not I. The shield commemorates your participation in the tourney. You may take it as a souvenir.
In that case, thanks.
Have you been instructed as to the tourney's challenges, prizes, and vows? If not, I do hope you will allow me to tell you about them.
Feels like I know everything I'd ever want to know about chivalric tourneys.
Splendid. In that case, you must make your vow. Upon what would you like to swear it?
I vow on the love of my lady, Triss Marigold, to respect the chivalric virtues.
May the gods succor you in your endeavors to overcome. A sign here, please, then fill out these forms. That is all I need from you. Now, as arranged by Guillaume, you shall be fitted with appropriate armor for the tourney.
Shiny.
You have also been assigned a tent for the tourney's duration. It stands near the arena. Good luck.
Sir Geralt v plišťivé zbroji. Teď, když už jsme oděni, přihlášeni, přísahali se na naši lásku Trisranun Sul, se můžeme vrhnout do první disciplíny, a to je střelba do terčů. Ostatní rytíři už jsou na místě a čeká se pouze na nás. Tak to pojďme vyhrát.
Geralt, well I'll be. Have you decided to turn knight-errant?
All jesting aside, here on a job. You in the tourney too?
Am I? Ha! I shall square off against Renfarn of Atre. I saw him just moments ago, a nervous wreck, stuffing his nose with fishtech, no less, as if that would aid his determination.
Guessing that's against the rules.
But who's to tell the Nilfgaardian what to do? Listen, Geralt, I've a tip for you. The timing of your marksmanship duel is such that you shall have the sun in your eyes.
Makes no difference to me either way.
Or will it give you any pleasure? Since, as it is, we must both wait, play me in a round of quint. Should you win, I shall swap with you. To me, a southerner, the sun is no hindrance.
Thanks. Another time, maybe.
Ha! You've denied me some diversion, but at the least my eyes are in for a treat. Lady Vivian should appear shortly.
Fair knights, I salute you! The honor and duty of tourney patron have fallen to me this year. Fight honorably, so that I may bestow upon one of your number the tourney's grand prize! You have sworn your vows, you have readied body and soul. The time has come to test them!
Behold Horm Akispark of the Mechtian royal line. His name's quite the mouthful, a true challenge to rhyme. His targets to be hit centrally and true are the ones in blue. Against him new blood, a knight unknown till now. Sir Geralt of Rivia, give us a bow. The targets he must with his quarrels thread are red. May the better man win.
Geraltova úklona je naprosto dechberoucí. Musíme získat víc terčů než protivník, stačí se střelovat červené terče. Tak, jde nám to moc pěkně, hezky od ruky. A teď mě trošku ujela ruka, nevadí.
Geralt jumps ahead, leaves the others behind. Sir Geralt of Rivia has trounced his foe, pounded him soundly, immersed him in woe.
Your prize, sir. A crossbow adorned with your crest. I congratulate you.
Thank you, my lady. My medallion's vibrating strongly. Can only mean one thing. Magic.
The explanation is disappointing, I'm afraid. The fragrance I use, it's mixed by a sorceress.
To lose to an opponent such as you is a victory of its own. Accept my congratulations as well.
Thanks.
Good work!
In the interim, I managed to determine which tent Lady Vivian occupies. Perhaps you could find a clue within it.
You're right. Vivian's cursed in some way. Sensed it when she opened the tourney.
In that case, we've no time to lose. Let us go.
Yeah, let's go now.
This is her tent. You must look inside. Search it. I shall hoot like an owl should someone approach.
Hlavní důvod, proč tady jsme, abys nezjistili, co je s Vivian de Tabaris. Jenom víme, že blízko ní zaklínecký medailon cítí magie. Tak to tady musíme pěkně prošetřit. Guillaume, neskládej tam básně a radši hlídej. A Mirko? Škrábance? V tom něco musí být.
His insults. Used to make compresses. Oriole feather. Vivian keep a bird as a pet? No sign of it here, if so. Ruxay tend to be fond of birds. Clothing's all dark green and yellow. Seems Yen's not the only one with a fixed color scheme.
Someone approaches. Quickly!
You were supposed to hoot.
We shall speak later. We must return to the tourney now. It's time for the second contest.
Sirs, what seek you in my lady's tent? Inspiration? Be gone from here!
Zatím jsme nenašli moc důkazů, které by nasvědčovaly to, že Vivian je prokletá. Teď se pojďme zúčastnit druhé disciplíny. Prodavač pamlsku, abyste se mohli koupit nějaké občerstvení. Nějaký ten šmetrlón nebo preclík, aby se nám dobře soutěžilo. Peníze máme, ale zase se čeká pouze na nás, takže pojďme se zúčastnit druhé disciplíny. Koňský přebor.
Behold, gallant knights and ladies decorous! Gaze at the host assembled before us! Look upon chivalry's best and most storied! Come from far lands, here to seek glory! Hear now their names as I shout them aloud! Savor their titles, of their presence be proud! Palmerin, the Baron of Lonfal! Linus of Metina! Rainfarn of Atra! Horm Macaspark of Maecht! Donimir of Troy! Guy de Boisfren, in service to the Duchess! Delwyn of Craigiau! Count Ty of Dondal! Ansay of Lyria and Rivia a Prince! Geralt of Rivia! For Gregoire of Mount Gorgon, let out a roaring cheer! The famed Fire of Silence, tawny champion from last year! Today's winner of contests, his victory to secure, shall face Sir Gregoire in a challenge severe!
Does ignorance demand a bard in deceit? Does someone need telling how tourneys proceed?
How dare you enter a tourney for nobly born knights? Your knighthood came through the grace of my mother, Meath, Queen of Lyria and Rivia, whom you treacherously deserted mere days later. Your presence here is an offense to my honor.
And yours is an offense to my eyes. If you're done, step aside. prince.
The Tawny's protector, the mate Vivien. Her beauty entrances both beasts and men.
My heart's greetings, dear knights. May my grace guide you and show you the path of honor, valor, and glory. Accept my wishes of good fortune, sir, and devote all your strength to the tourney, and only it.
The time has come for you, sir knight. Mount your steed, swift be your flight. Ladies and gentlemen of lineage illustrious, soon steeds shall swarm like ants most industrious. To beat time's passage, they'll ride like the gale. What a sight to behold, what a lark, what a tale! Before us, Geralt, from Rhythia come, fast as the wind, bright as the sun.
Geralt začíná, rychle jsem dal na klepnu rytířskou výstroj a vyrážíme. Není to nic těžké, stačí se prostě držet cesty a dojet do konce, aniž by vám unikl čas. Díky těmto panákům si můžete nakupit čas a potom tu budou ještě terče, které fungují stejně jako panáci. Získáte nějaký ten bonusový čas k dobru. Když se toho budete držet, budete strefovat se do terčů, oni myslím, že stačí bohatě jenom ty panáci, tak byste měli krásně dojet až do konce. Lyrijský a rivijský princ určitě bude chtít nějakou tu satisfakci. Proč je vlastně lyrijský a rivijský princ náš naštvaný? Protože při bitvě u mostu, když Geralt se svojí družinou šel osvobodit Ciri, potřebovali přijít přes ten most. Sám Geralt to řekl a díky tady té statečnosti v obraně mostu ho lyrijská královna Meave pasovala na syra Geralta ze Rivie. Natož asi pár dnů potom Geralt musel opustit tábor. Mezi tou družinou právě patřili i Regis a Regis pomohl jeho kompany opustit rivijský tábor. Takže takhle to vlastně bylo. Protože Geralt potřeboval cestovat dál. Geralt potřeboval zachránit Ciri.
A race of such style, such grace, such speed. To watch was a pleasure, a treat indeed. To honor our entrance, praise each fair knight. We shall feast from eve till dawn's first light. The finest of wine and food shall be served. If you've blood in your veins, come collect what's deserved.
I congratulate you. Here, your prize. A saddle adorned with your crest.
Many thanks.
By the way, my maid saw a man with white hair sneak out of my tent. Would you know who it might have been?
No idea.
How juvenile.
Congratulations on your win. In stellar style, no less. Ah, I no longer regret I was not able to participate. Almost.
We must drink to this. Come with me to the feast. We shall await Vivien together.
Lead the way.
So, any thoughts on Vivien?
Her beauty's striking.
That is not what I ask.
Still too early to say anything I'd be willing to stand behind. Found some clues. Got me wondering if your beloved Vivian's not a Bruxa.
A Bruxa? You mean a vampiress?
Not sure yet.
We've still some time before Vivien arrives. Let us drink. To Vivien, may you find the means to aid her.
To Vivien.
Ah, when I first laid eyes on her, I finally understood what all those poems and ballads were trying to say.
Love's not poetry alone. Sometimes it's prose. Sometimes it's just plain ugly.
You say that only because you do not know Vivien as I do. A life with her would be sweetness itself.
Actually, you don't know her all that well either.
Your presence at this tourney is an affront to my honor. I demand satisfaction.
Head to the nearest brothel, then.
Coward! Mounted combat in the main arena. I challenge you.
Since you insist, I'm all yours.
You shall bitterly regret deserting my mother's army once I'm done with you. May the blood I will spill wash away the stain of your cowardice!
Let's get this over with. Quick.
3, 2, 1!
Ten princ je tak otravný. Ten princ je jako vyrážka, která nejde poškrábat. On si prostě nedá pokoj. Tak jo, tady máš tu svoji satisfakci. Ještě bych se ale musel trefit.
For reasons unknown except to them, the gods have chosen to punish me with defeat. But do not think your cowardice will be forgotten.
Damn it. You still going on about that? Need to clear this up once and for all. Had to abandon your mother's camp back then because someone else needed my help. Badly. Couldn't refuse them. Didn't want to, in fact.
You mean to say you had a secret mission, set off to accomplish it, having vowed to tell no one of its nature, until you did?
Something like that, minus the vow. And, I'd still rather not divulge the nature of my secret mission. Can you accept that as justification?
In agreeing to duel, you proved yourself a true knight. Thus, I accept your word as that of a man of honor.
Glad to hear it. Now I got work to do.
My heart swells to behold this beautiful celebration of valor and honor, and to witness you, who embody the chivalric virtues in your lives, strive for greatness. Yet, after a time of combat must come a time of peace and respite. Thus, I invite all who fought in the tourney to this feast held in your, and none other's, honor. And should any among you crave solitude, private tents await you nearby. The group melee shall take place on the morrow. Glory shall be within grasp for each and every one of you. The best among you shall have the honor to face our reigning champion, the famed Grégoire de Gourgon, victor of last year's tourney. Celebrate, make merry, revel as you will, yet be mindful of the trial that awaits you tomorrow.
Follow her. We shall meet in your tent before your last contest. You must help her.
Teďka bychom konečně mohli zjistit, co se to tady děje za pikle. Ostatní rytíři budou oslavovat, my jako jediní opustíme hostinu. Máš nějaký problém? Jediný šílenec si toho všimnul. Doufám, že nepromluví. Tady je nějaký panoš. Jak vidím, tak tady o strom je opřený nějaký panoš, který ho jeho pán totálně zřídil. Nošení brnění, nošení mečů, nošení postroj na koně. Prostě těžký život panoše.
Strange. Was sure I'd find her here. Vanished. Melted into thin air. And that bird. She a Bruxa?
Zvláštností je to, že když jsme vešli do stanu, tak kdyby jen tady nebyla. A jediný, co tady bylo, byl tam ten ptáček. Takže ho budeme následovat a uvidíme, kam nás dovede. Přešel jsem jeskyni a dostal jsem se k tuji uprostřed lesa.
Witcher.
Lady Vivian? Counted on me getting lost.
I did. I thought you no different from the knights. Good at tourneys, hopeless in the face of true danger. I was mistaken.
So you're not actually a Bruxa?
A what?
Suspicion I had that you might be a vampire. Certain details seemed to confirm it. Then I changed my mind. Anyway, unimportant. Here you come to this clearing often.
This is where it all began. And as I was not able to evade you, save myself from you, then I want it done here. In this very spot, with no witnesses.
Want what done?
Why, you are a witcher. You were hired to kill me, were you not? Then do so, now. And do it quickly, I beg you. I shan't resist.
Witchers only hunt monsters, and even then, not all. You're no monster.
Then what am I to your eyes?
Most likely you've been cursed. Don't know who by or why yet, but hope to find that out soon.
If you've no contract on my life, why take an interest at all? Did Guillaume put you up to it? Is that why?
He wanted to help you. Asked me to do him a favor. Frankly, if I can do something for you, I'll do it, willingly.
Why should I trust you?
'Cause the Duchess trusts me. 'Cause I'm a freak, too. 'Cause cases like yours are my bread and butter. Take your pick.
You shall not turn on me. Use what I say against me. You shall not tell anyone.
Can't promise anything till I hear what you have to say. Decisions based on appearances? Not a good idea. Regretted making those too often in the past.
So be it. I shall tell you what my mama once told me. When she was with child, expecting me, she and my father spent much time together near the wood, here in this clearing. Mama loved to listen to the orioles sing. She would stroke her belly and say, "My daughter should be as beautiful as that bird. Such is my wish." But a creature dwelt in the wood who envied my parents their happiness. One day it appeared before them to say the whole wood belonged to it, and they had dared to delight in something that was not theirs. It demanded payment, and when my parents said that they had nothing, it claimed their unborn daughter as its own.
What happened after that?
Nothing at first. I came into the world a perfectly normal child, and my parents forgot that day's events. But 15 summers into my life, the curse began to show. Initially only when the moon was full. But now it's advanced so that even in daytime I must use magic ointment to mask its symptoms, to look normal. Thus I thought someone had discovered my secret, then hired you to kill me. In fact, I was resigned to death in coming here. Perhaps death would be preferable to my complete and permanent transformation. For I fear that is what lies in store.
The curse. It could be reversible. Once ran into a baron transformed into a cormorant, ostensibly for good. Managed to cure him completely.
And you truly think you could do something like this for me?
Can't guarantee a thing. Tough case, yours. You were cursed before birth. That alone complicates things. Also, you claim the curse is increasing its hold. Symptoms are progressing. Could try transferring the curse onto someone else.
What? Out of the question. I shall not allow it to ruin an innocent life. Is this the only method you know?
Only one that's completely safe.
So there is another.
All right, there is another. Ancient ritual. We'd need an Oriole egg. Should release the curse's grip permanently. Gotta warn you, though. Could have serious consequences.
Consequences? What kind?
Curse was cast before you came into this world. Ritual involved transferring it to an as-yet-unhatched chick. You'd be free. Thing is, you could be left with the average lifespan of an Oriole.
7 years. I understand. Alas, every rose has its thorn, and there are no happy endings. Yet truth be told, I never thought I would get one. I came here prepared to die, yet you wish to give me 7 years of life. Real life, free life. This is no dilemma. I agree, wholeheartedly.
I see why. I understand. Don't have to decide just yet. Think it through.
I will. They must miss me at the Tawny Grounds by now. Shall we? Return.
Let's. But are you gonna...
Yes. I cannot appear there all in feathers. Pardon me for a moment.
Change at will?
No, but I discovered the water of this pool helps. Its effects are brief, but I can always be sure of them.
Interesting.
Come.
Did you learn anything?
Yeah.
Then speak, man. Can you not see I'm out of my mind with worry? What ails her?
She asked me not to talk about it.
But I want only the best for her. Perhaps I shall be able to help or, I don't know, console her at the least.
Další morální rozhodnutí. Teď se musíme rozmyslet, jestli mu to řekneme, nebo ne. To je zase těžké rozhodnutí. Ona chtěla, aby jsme to neřekli, ale zbývá jí jenom 7 let života. Mají lepší šanci na záchranu. A toho právě můžeme využít skrze Guillauma. Guillaume nás najmul na tuhle zakázku. Guillaume ji chce zachránit. Guillaume chce dělat všechno pro to, aby přežila. A podle mě je kravina ho do toho nezapojit. Protože ještě kdybychom ho do toho nezapojili, tak by našel nejbližší strom, na kterým by se oběsil. A to my určitě nechceme mít na našem bedru. Takže mu to řekneme.
We were both right, actually. It is a curse. One that's transforming Vivian into a bird. Her condition's getting worse.
Gods! A curse that is a worse affliction than disease. What now? Can you help her?
That'll depend on her. I'll try if she asks me. Significant risks involved, though. Shortening her life to about another 7 years included.
What? This is not what we agreed.
Tough case. Curse's hold on her grows stronger every day, and I'm a witcher, not a miracle worker. Heard of one other method that could work. Curse could be lifted via her reflection, say in a pool of water. Thing is, we'd need someone who'd willingly assume the burden of the curse. Take it on in her stead.
You mean, become a bird themselves?
Theoretically. See, curse grows weaker once it's transferred. Might end up as just an appetite for seeds and worms. All outcomes are on the table, though. Death included.
I am prepared to sacrifice. Give my life for her. Just as King Friedank's knight did for the beautiful Queen Sero.
Knew that already. But are you prepared to swallow bugs for the rest of your life?
Yes. Which method do you believe to be best for Vivian?
Don't know yet.
But you have some notion, have you not? Do not tell me you seriously consider drastically shortening her life when I stand prepared to shoulder the burden.
Method using a pool of water is better. Poses no threat to Vivian.
Naturally. You must know you can count on me. I shall bear it all. But Vivian, I fear she might be too proud to agree to such a thing.
I'll meet her after the last contest. Talk to her. She could agree.
I'm counting on you, Witcher. And I'm content we finally know something. What now? We know all, so you need not see the tourney through. You could withdraw. True, I shall get an earful from the Herald should you fail to show for the last contest. But it's nothing I can't handle. So, what will it be?
No, v poslední řadě turnaj, který mám v plánu jistě dokončit.
I don't back out of anything. I'll take part in the last skirmish. Besides, Vivian will be busy till the tourney's end.
Indeed. In that case, you must meet the other knights of your team. They await near the arena's entrance, by the training ground.
Got it. Thanks.
I know now the two teams' rosters. I shall be captain of ours. That means you shall do as I say for the duration of the fight. Is this clear? Palmer and Alonso will lead the opposing team. With this skirmish, we commemorate the Battle of Fox Hollow of 1218, when a handful of southern outlaws led by Hallar the Brown attacked Tucson only to be driven off by brave knights, thus setting a precedent. Since that day, knights errant have guarded the duchy's borders. Palmerin drew the short straw, so his team shall play the barbarian Hallar's men. Any questions?
None.
I doubt you will do us any good. You know nothing of knightly combat as a witcher. Try at least to stay out of our way.
It is time, gentlemen. Take your weapons and proceed to the arena.
A cheer for the knights, the ladies, the lords. For our next entertainment, the team shall cross swords. Two rifle crews, two coteries shall fight full tilt till one drops to its knees. Who virtue ignores or lance blows unclean shall forever be branded as shameful, obscene. While the knights prepare, let me say I'm elated to behold such a crowd on edge, breath bated. Whoever here wins, the past champion shall face. All others must leave, heads bowed in disgrace.
Je docela škoda, že Tyles bojuje na naší straně, protože by si mohl odníst i nějakou tu další zvod Geralta. Nevadí, koho si zaměříme. A tamhle vidím Palmerina, tak pojď Palmerine. Palmer mě nevidí. Útočit dozad, to není zrovna rytířské, ale teď jste dva, takže můžu používat jisté taktiky. Ale znamení bych se chtěl vyvarovat. Guy de Buffet, to je vzdálený bratranec jednoho zesnulého Geraltova přítele. A ještě tady jaké Sparka, který bojoval proti nám ve střeleckém turnaji.
The world's never seen a fight quite so glorious. For showing such verve, each knight was victorious. Yet in tourneys as in life, but one champion may reign. Today, he is the one. Praised be his name. He felt a whole host slew the most.
to Geralt of Rivia, who the strength of lions boasts. He sails through all trials. Each test he passed with ease. But now awaits the last. Will it bring him to his knees? For Gregoire de Gorgon, who on this ground's last won, shall spar him for the title, and the day is done. To the tired Tremender, we salute your endeavors. Return to your wives, your loves, your whomevers. It is time. Step into the arena. Should you suffer grievous harm during combat, have you any last wishes, any missives you wish passed to your loved ones?
Thanks, I'm fine.
The Witcher of Rivia, Geralt his name. Though aged be his visage, do not disdain. His locks true are white, but he was born to fight. Now entering the grounds, a titan of infamy, Gregoire de Gorgon, victor of Lassie's tourney!
I wish both combatants good fortune and fame!
Jelikož jsme porazili nejvíc protivníků, tak nás tady čeká šampion, Gregoire de Gorgon, alias Easter Egg na Hry o trůny. Tak jo, máme tady zaklínačskou verzi hory. Cože to je hora, masa a jeho úder by skolil slona, vůbec nepomůže, protože Geralt, ten je rychlej jako lasička. Budu se tady kolem něho otáčet, až se mu zatočí z toho hlava. No ještě pár úderů a je konec. Gregoire de Gorgon ztratí svůj titul šampion.
Geralt of Rivia! This year's champion! A sight to behold! He defeated Gregoire de Gorgon! Hail, Geralt! Herald! Herald! Herald!
As patron of this grand tourney, I've the honor to decorate our grand champion. His vow he made upon his love for his heart's captor, and it was doubtless this vow that carried him to this splendid victory! He showed great courage, great strength, great composure. He fought nobly with honor, and thus rightfully deserves the title of this year's Champion of the Arena!
I need to talk to you.
Not now. We shall meet later in my tent. I have duties to attend to, as do you. Folk regard you. The least you should do is wave.
Greetings, my lady. Have you decided?
I have. I stand by all I have said. I wish to endanger no one and thus choose the method involving an egg. If it's to be the egg of an oriole, I know where to find one. There is a nest in my clearing. Might you explain the nature of the ritual? Its exact course?
Sure. Want to tell you something, though. Think we should try the alternate method first.
I was clear. It is out of the question.
Let me finish. Second method's less than reliable. To put it simply, might work, might not.
But it will. I shall save you, oh lovely Vivian.
Why are you here, sir? This is a private conversation.
No need to be sharp with him, my lady. And if I'm to help you, gotta do one thing for me. Hear what Guillaume has to say.
Is that an ultimatum?
Looks to be.
Be not angry, my lady. You no longer bear this burden alone. I know all.
You told him?
I know a curse afflicts you, a curse which grows more severe by the day. I understand how you feel. My aunt, Countess de Lawnful, once contracted a strange illness which ate away at her from the inside. She grew weaker by the day, the light fading from her eyes. I remember her saying the worst was not the pain, but losing mastery of her own body. She was so helpless. I fear you feel the same. The Witcher knows a way to lift the curse from you and let it rest on me. I wish to do this, to take it from you, Vivian.
Why?
Because I love you. I might have died in the arena. I sought to slay a Shalmar for you. But now I see the fool I was. Now I see how I risked my life for no purpose. Yet, with this, I can truly do something for you.
I do not wish to inflict this horror on anyone. You saw how it looks, Witcher. I turn to you as one elder and hopefully one wiser as well. Do you think this a good idea?
Worth a try, as I see it. Original curse fell on an unborn child. Doubt it'll take hold as strongly when transferred to a full-grown man.
You've now heard the expert opinion. Let us do this together, Vivian.
Very well. I was prepared to die. Thus, I am also prepared to attempt something mad. Now, we must go to my pool in the woods, yes?
Everything's agreed, so no point wasting any more time. Let's go.
So, this is my true form. It is not too late. You may still change your mind. It will bring no shame.
My mind is made up. My resolve is firm. If you can handle it, so will I. You are beautiful to me, even as you stand now.
Oh, that's clearly rubbish.
Shut your eyes, both of you, and don't move.
Guillaume?
Yes, my love?
If you become as I am now, I wish you to know I shall not leave you.
Picture yourselves reflected in a pool of water. Focus on that. Open your eyes. Damn. Think it might have worked. How do you feel? In general, you feel it change, Guillaume?
I was struck hard, as if by a battering ram, but now I feel not at all different. Apart from a slight itch on my skin. Are you certain it worked?
Yes, something happened, definitely. Must be an intersection beneath this pond. Powerful magic at work here. Look at Vivian.
What now?
Now? Now you get to live together. Happily ever after. Still, watch yourselves carefully. Notice any troubling symptoms, find me.
Naturally. I thank you, Geralt. Oh, and your payment.
At last! I've so much to make up for. Balls to attend, distant lands to see.
Free at last, as a bird.
Huh? I found you droll. I had not noticed before.
But you will not fly away without me.
That remains to be seen, I think. But I too must thank you, Witcher.
Don't mention it. You take care, both.
Myslím, že náš úkol je u konce. Tyhle dvě hrdličky jsme dali dohromady, necháme je tady o samotě. A myslím, že se s nima ještě uvidíme, to rozhodně, během příběhu. Každopádně, tady bych se s vámi chtěl rozloučit. V příští epizodě budou pravděpodobně ještě nějaké ty vedlejší úkoly. A přemýšlím, že bychom si udělali takovou odlehčenou epizodu plnou poezie a umění. Prostě sami uvidíte, co jsem pro vás připravil. Vám, že se vám líbil ten úkol, cvrlikání zaláskovaného rytíře a uvidíme se příště. Takže, naschle.